Forgive the MySpace angle. I just didn't want to grab all this stuff or something this quick.
This is a video response to somebody, I believe his name is Happy Cabby. His video is going to be down there. He talks a little bit about DMCA stuff, so if you've had a DMCA claim filed against you, I'd take a look at his video. He's got some very good points.
What I want to do is I want to add a slight addendum to what he has put out there.
This is concerning false DMCA claims. A simple search for false DMCA claim in the search bar up there someplace, and you're going to see dozens of videos that are basically saying the same thing that I'm about to tell you. And that is that a lot of people and corporations are filing false DMCA claims, and sometimes they're doing it like they're just doing blanket DMCA claims so that they can try to nail everybody all at once. But a lot of times, a lot of people are filing false DMCA claims for various reasons. And in order to understand what those are, I need to tell you what happens when you file a DMCA claim. The moment you file a Digital Millennium Copyright Act claim against somebody else, that video is immediately taken down off of YouTube. And then it is up to the victim, it is up to the person who's accused of stealing copyrighted material, it's up to you to prove your innocence. And the way you do that is that you send all of your personal information to YouTube, and then you basically plead your case. Now, what YouTube does with that information is that they forward it to whoever filed the DMCA claim against you. So your personal information that you are typing in is going to whoever filed the DMCA claim against you. Now, it's important to know this because, well, this is the problem with the system. Number one, some people are using it to fish for information. They're using it to try to get your personal information, and then once they have your personal information, they're going to use it to either try to steal your identity or whatever reasons people have that they would want to have your information. So people have been doing that. And the other one, and this is relatively new to me, is that what people are doing is they're using it as a method of trolling. They're filing a false DMCA claim, then they get your information, and then they spread your information around so that people will be calling you in the middle of the night, people will be sending you harassing emails, they might even send you some nasty stuff in the real mail, somebody could show up at your doorstep. You don't know. Because you're just sending out your information to an unknown entity, and YouTube doesn't check. So, sort of an addendum to his DMCA video, so check his out. But as an addendum to that, if somebody files a DMCA claim against you, against one of your videos, first thing you want to do is do your homework. Find out if the person is legitimate. Find out if they actually do represent a company that they say they represent. If somebody goes by the name of John Doe, whatever, 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 and they file a false DMCA claim and they claim that they represent Viacom or Warner or some other large company, that should send up some red flags. Now, just as a point of notice here, somebody filed a false DMCA claim against me and the name sent up some red flags. I did some research on the guy, and when I filed a counter notification, I did not include my personal information. I didn't include my address, I didn't include my phone number, and my video was reinstated within maybe a day or so. So, if somebody files a false claim against you and you can prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that the person is either trolling for information or trying to fish for information or something like that, file the counterclaim anyway, but just don't include your personal information and express your concern, your heavy concern that you're being fished. And YouTube, for all the nasty things that we tend to say about YouTube, they actually do some intelligent things once in a while. So just keep that in mind. So this is just sort of an addendum to his video. Check out his video. I also recommend you do a little bit of homework on your own. Check for false DMCA claims on YouTube. You'll see all sorts of fun stuff. So, yeah. Cheers.